Channel. So for this week's video, I am sharing with you a DIY super chunky knit throw blanket. Now, I have seen these things all over Pinterest, all over just the internet in general, and I've always wanted one for myself, but I really wanted the super, super chunky knit blanket. And if you know anything about them, you know that they are super expensive. So this project is kind of like a journey to discover the cheapest way to get this style of chunky knit blanket. Disclaimer, it's still not super cheap, but the techniques in this video can be used with other yarns and other materials that aren't quite as expensive as the wool yarn that I used in this blanket. Now, as in all of my videos, I'm going to show you how I went through it, the mistakes that I made, things that I would have done differently, and, you know, show you the real behind the scenes of this project. I know there are many different videos on how to make chunky knit blankets out there, but a lot of them left out key things that I personally needed to know in order to make this, so hopefully I can answer those for you, and hopefully you enjoy the video. So without further ado, let's get into the video. So this is the yarn that I used. I got this from Michaels. It is not a cheap yarn, but I made sure that every ball of yarn that I got was half off. Now the ball of yarn comes in this twisted form, but I really wanted it to be as chunky as possible, so I decided to untwist it. This is a completely optional step. You do not have to do this if you don't want to. I'm just crazy. So to start your chunky knit blanket, you're going to take the tail, which is the end piece right here. You're going to make a loop and pull that string through, and then pull both strings together to create a slip knot. After you make your slip knot, you're going to create a chain. To make the chain, I simply used the width of my knuckles as a measurement for how big to make the loops, because you want them to be uniform. You stick your hand through there, and then you pull the yarn up through that loop. And then you continue to do this until you get to the width of the blanket that you want. Once you get the blanket to the width that you want it to be, you're going to want to leave that last loop that you made, go over two stitches backwards, and pull the yarn up through there and create another loop the same size. In my case, just the width of my knuckles. And then you just continue that on all the way back the other way. Once you get to the last one, you're going to want to make that last loop. And this is the only time you're going to do this next step. You're going to take your yarn and pull it through that same loop that you just made. Now, this is the only time you're going to do this. If you keep doing this, your blanket will get very, very wide. Then you just go through and you loop through the loops that you made before. Now once you get to the other end and you've made that last loop there, you're going to skip that one and then go back on the second stitch. And the same thing on this side. You're going to make your final loop, skip that first one, and do the second one.
Okay, so I have a problem. I have made it this far in the width of it, and it looks pretty good. I mean, it's not gonna be perfect. It's hand knit, so it's gonna have some discrepancies. But what I have done two times now, I didn't film the first time, is I've made it too wide. I'm gonna drape this over the side of the table. Look at how wide I've made this. It's just really wide, and you want it to be the size of a throw blanket. So here it is with a throw blanket on top of it. It's almost double the width of a throw blanket. I guess I just started out with too many stitches. So what I think I'm gonna do is take it apart and redo it.
So I went ahead and just repeated the same process to start this blanket again, but I made it less wide this time. Now, a part of the project that I didn't see many other tutorials show is how to add another ball of yarn to your blanket. So what you do is when you reach the end of your first ball of yarn, you take the new ball of yarn and you cross it the other way, and then you just continue on like it's just one string, but it's actually two. When you go back over it, you just continue on the same way as before. And that extra little tail right there, I just tucked behind there and we'll take care of that at the end. So once you've reached the length of the blanket that you want, you're going to want to loop that final stitch there, pull the yarn behind it, and grab the next stitch over together with the last stitch, and then loop them together. So you're basically making two stitches, one stitch. And you just continue that on over the whole width of the blanket. So once you get to that last stitch, you're gonna have the one loop left. You're gonna wanna pull the yarn through it and then pull it tight. Now with that extra tail there, you're just gonna wanna weave that in through the loops. And you do that with the other end where you started as well. Now for those extra little tails where you added new balls of yarn, you're just going to want to tuck those in like the other ones. And this is what it looks like all finished. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I really hope you enjoyed it. I hope it inspires you to make a chunky knit blanket of your own. I'm actually going to try to do another one, but it's going to be a completely different version. It's going to be where I make my own yarn, because this yarn in particular is not washable. Like, you have to hand wash it, which is kind of a bummer because it's a huge blanket and washing it's going to be a nightmare. But the new blanket that I want to make is going to be of washable yarn. So it's going to be fabric and stuffing in the yarn, so it's gonna be like super chunky still. I haven't fully decided if I'm going to do that because that seems like a lot of work. So if you guys would be interested in that, let me know and I'll make that. Now I will put a full disclosure out there that this blanket is not the cheapest blanket on the planet, but it is much cheaper than buying the $200, $300, $400 chunky knit blankets online. I am going to be putting together a full comparison video of affordable chunky knit blankets in tiers based on level of chunk, quality of material, the softness, the washability. But yeah, that will be the next video coming out, so stay tuned for that. And hopefully you guys are excited for that, because I'm excited to share it with you. One last thing before I go, I just wanted to remind you guys that there is 1 week left on the 20K giveaway on my channel. So if you want to enter, I will include the giveaway link in this video description as well, so you can enter and be eligible to win the prizes. If you haven't seen the giveaway video, I will also put that in the description as well. That's all I have for you guys. I really hope you liked this video, and I hope you guys all have amazing weeks, and I will see you guys in the next video. As always. Bye guys!